So, unfortunately, I didn't get to review Room when it was first released in theaters. But, as luck would have it, this is actually the second best time to review Room for two reasons. The first, obviously, is that it is a major awards contender and awards winner at the Golden Globes. But the second reason, which I believe is lesser known because they haven't really let anyone know, is that this coming weekend, this weekend, it is getting somewhat of an expansion theatrically. It's not going wide. However, this weekend, the odds are more in your favor that you can see the movie in theaters relatively close to your home. So check Fandango, see if Room is going to pop up in any movie theaters near you, because I really do feel that it's worth a look. And I qualify it for the following reason. The person that I went to see the movie with felt it was super boring, like a real chore to get through. And then I was talking to someone else about the movie after having seen it, and I was like, wow, I was surprised by Room. I liked Room. I can see why it's a major awards contender. Are you gonna see it? And the person turned to me and said, you know, I realize it's an awards contender. I respect your opinion, but the subject matter is just a little bit too creepy for me, and I just don't view that as something that I want to go and see in a theater as, you know, quote unquote, entertainment, even if it is Oscar entertainment. And I have to say, I feel that both of those opinions, boring and creepy, are valid, and I think that they are indeed obstacles for Room. Now, with the creepy factor, there are just some people who are not going to be able to get past that, and I think that we should, as I said, respect that. But in the movie's defense, it's not an Oscar bait creepiness, right? I think this movie is sophisticated enough that it goes beyond that. I mean, let's be fair, any movie about this type of subject matter knows that it's going to be an awards contender because this is the exact kind of, you know, like in your face, ripped from the headlines, you know, touchy-feely stuff awards voters love. But this movie's more than that. However, I think that also to be fair, Room is very tasteful in the way it handles the subject matter. This is a movie about this relationship between a kidnapped woman and her son, not a kidnapped woman and her kidnapper. That element is, of course, still there, but I think this movie is as tastefully done as can be with such a subject matter. But again, some people just aren't going to be able to get past that, and we shouldn't force anyone to watch Room, even if it is a really good movie. Now, as for the boring part, I wasn't bored, but I can see how somebody would be. And quite frankly, you're not going to know if you'd be bored watching Room unless you see it. So my feeling is, because it's tastefully done, you don't have to worry about anything, you know, really icky being shown. And it's so interesting, and there's the potential for it to be good, and it has so many awards nominations. I feel if the worst thing that happens is that you're bored during the movie, so be it. It's worth a roll of the dice because you might not be. Just like I was. I was fascinated. And the main reason that I was fascinated by this movie was the young actor Jacob Tremblay, who I think was just absolutely amazing to the point where I actually kind of felt it was his film and that Brie Larson was really more of a supporting actress, especially considering the second half of the movie, which largely focuses almost entirely on him. And he holds the screen with again, some very difficult and sophisticated, subject matter. So I thought that was really great. In fact, I haven't seen a child actor this good since Haley Joel Osment and Dakota Fanning. But hopefully, on that note, things work out a little better for Jacob than they have for Haley and Dakota. But right now, oh, he's in that child actor sweet spot. Although it's not doing Abraham Otta any favors, but we will be talking about him momentarily towards the end of this review. But he was really, really good. Another thing that I liked about the movie, besides Jacob Tremblay, and which really kept me engaged, was that I felt it was a whole story. I felt it was complete. A lot of times when you're watching these avant-garde, artistic indie films, you're like, man, I really hope I get to see that scene, or I get to see that moment, because they're building toward it, it's a huge part of the story, I want to be there, I want to witness it. And then the movie, like, actually, in my opinion, often can't live up to its own hype that it's generated, and it knows it. So these are other movies. So they'll cut away, or they'll end the movie right before that scene, and they're like, oh, you can imagine it. We're gonna leave it up to you. Aren't we artistic? But the great thing that I love about Room is that It gives you those scenes. It gives you those moments. And so it really creates a complete experience, which I feel is intentional, not only because it's good filmmaking and storytelling, but I think that very much ties into the way the movie ends as well, which is, again, a really sophisticated way to make a movie. So I really, really appreciated that. Now, also something else that I think in terms of the creepiness factor of the movie is that it does address some of the difficult questions that Brie Larson's character is presented with or was presented with in her ordeal. And it doesn't shy away from saying, did she make the right choice? I feel that she did make the right choices in every instance. I think she made the best choices she could at the moment that she made them with the information that she had and at the age that she was. I don't want to give any spoilers away, but I respected the movie for asking that question. And I think everyone's going to have a little bit of a different answer, which is, again, very interesting. Now, also a critique leveled at this movie that I've seen, which I can also agree with, is that in real life, the situation probably would have been much worse. Now, the phenomenon of someone kidnapping someone for the long term and not for the short term is obviously a very twisted and strange animal. And that lends itself a little bit to this movie, you know, not having such a horrific outcome to some degree, and not being like a real, like, I don't know, like torture porn movie that it could have become. But also in that regard, I think that the movie's very literary. It is very much like the novel that it is, right? It almost has fairy tale-like elements to it. And I think I think you have to understand that. That it isn't 110% realistic. I think it's as realistic as it can be, while still being a little bit of a quote-unquote story. But I think that the movie was able to maintain that vibe impressively because it had the author adapt the book into a screenplay. And I think this is a wonderful development in Hollywood where the novelists get to adapt their material to a different medium. It's tough to do, but so far we see a lot of people succeeding. Gone Girl, I think, succeeded in this manner, and now I feel Room does as well. And this is really an actor's movie and a screenwriter's movie, a writer's movie. I think that Lenny Abramson does a pretty good job directing. It's more stylistic at the beginning of the movie. Like, I was like, oh, hey, you know, maybe he should have gotten a nod. And then I double-checked the nominations when I left the theater, and I was like, oh, yeah, he did. I can see that. But having watched the entire movie, I really don't think that Lenny Abramson is what pulls this together, especially because he directed Frank with Michael Fassbender, and I felt that was a mess. So I think that Lenny Abramson isn't consistent. This author turned screenwriter because of this, and Brie Larson, you know, short-term 12, but she's relatively new to the game as well, so I don't think we can call anybody here reliable in what they deliver. But I know for a fact that Lenny Abramson doesn't always deliver. Sometimes he like majorly drops the ball. But I really like this movie, and I really wanted to bring up again, as I said, Abraham Atta. And I feel that after you see Room, you'll feel just like with Beasts of No Nation, that both Jacob Tremblay and Abraham Atta were robbed of their Oscar nominations. I mean, really, some of the finest acting that we've seen this year from anyone of any age. So for them not to get nominated, I think is really unfortunate. I also think it's interesting to have two movies that, when you think about it, show two young boys in just absolutely horrible situations. And when you can take away from the comparison to some degree is what a difference a mom can make. And I think that in itself is a beautiful message and one of the hallmarks of Room. Really, just the bond between mother and son. I talked about this with The Fifth Wave a little bit. The Fifth Wave, not a good movie, but I really like this new trend of showing healthy families, well, to a degree, obviously, but healthy family relationships, positive ones. I think family is some of the most important bonds that people can have, and I think for too long, popular culture has tried to make them seem uncool. So to show how important they are and how transformative they can be and what a lifeline they can be, is, I think, quite commendable, and one of the chief reasons that I enjoyed this movie so much, along with Jacob Tremblay's performance and the writing. I believe Emma Donahue is the name. All right, thank you so much for tuning into my review. Thank you for your patience in me getting this out there, and I look forward to discussing the movie with you down below. If you're going to discuss spoilers, be sure to put a lot of, returns and the spoiler warning so that you don't ruin it for anybody. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.